Hello, it's Lynda Cromar coming to you from my home office in Colorado. And as the title says, you have to have a fine line between being grateful and being in the mode of dreaming of what you want that is better than where you are now. Now, and often I see a lot of people that just don't get that they have a lot to be happy about. Does that mean you settle? Not necessarily. But I'll give you a story to help you out here. When I was single, this was many years ago now, because I've been married to my husband, my second husband and love of my life, for over 30 years. We just celebrated our 30th anniversary in June. And one of the things that I realized when I was divorced and single, living in Longmont, Colorado, and not real happy with where I was, is I spent a lot of time just believing and caring for where I wanted to be. And it was not easy to be happy where I was. But the thing is that you need to have both if you truly want to create a better life for yourself. There is something kind of special that kind of unlocks something creative and really good inside of a person when they really learn how to be grateful. Grateful for things you have, grateful for blessings you've received if you believe in that, grateful for other people in your life that have done things for you. When you can do that, you're not as likely to be complaining as much about where you are. And the fact that many complain more than they feel good about where they are is often something that shuts down the ability to think ahead at what could be accomplished, what you can accomplish, what you can do, and where you can see yourself. Because they really go hand in hand. Complaining and dreaming never works together, but grateful and dreaming does. I hope that makes sense to you. If it does, please absolutely give me a like. Whenever you let yourself be grateful and get good at handling what you have first, before you go on to dream about something better, you can have something better. I know, that sounds like an oxymoron. It sounds like it's opposite of what's the truth. And yes, you have to have some angst and some drive also. You can't be settling where you are. Gratefulness doesn't mean that you don't drive yourself for more. It just means that you realize that you've achieved some things. And gratefulness is not about believing that you're so good that you did it all, but that you actually believe either in God or another kind of higher power. I myself believe in Christ, and so that's who I put my gratefulness on. But you know, absolutely have to have that to drive yourself further. I guess it also goes along with hope. If you don't have gratefulness and hope, then where does your emotions go? It goes into being angry and being upset and feeling like a victim. So you can't be grateful and feel like a victim. So those are, see, there's positive emotions and there's negative emotions, all of which absolutely change how, what kind of spirit, what kind of energy you send out when you do any of the things that you do to build your business. If you are sending out feelings of victimhood, feeling unfairly treated, you're not going to attract people to you, and they're not going to be anxious to look at what you have. You have to show that you love where you are, even though it's not necessarily where you want to finish. In other words, when I was single and I was hoping for more, the one thing I did do that was correct is I prayed a lot. And I was blessed with the opportunity to have more in my life. I was, you know, blessed to meet the man I am now married to for 30 some years. And it also goes along with who you're going to meet and who you're going to connect with when it comes to business as well. I was grateful to meet many of the people that have become my mentors, teachers, and helpers towards what I want to do in my life. I have a lot to be grateful for. I have a lot of things I'm happy about, but I'm also still striving to make my life even better. Mainly to make it so that my husband will not have to continue to work. It's hard to see somebody that's getting older and yet still working. And many people are still in that same place. The major thing is connect up your positive emotion of gratefulness with your dreaming. And then, of course, always you must take action. Then you will come to a place where you'll start to see real results. People that join you because they can feel that positive energy inside of you instead of negative people feeling like they're unhappy, people feeling like they got treated badly, they're victims. Nobody wants to connect up with that kind of energy. So you got to make sure that you connect up with the right kind of energy so that you can achieve what you want, when you want, and then start taking all kinds of action. With those positive energies and the action, you will see results. You won't see it just from dreaming. You won't see it just from being grateful. It's a combination of those three things. Gratefulness, the energy of a dream that you believe you can achieve, and the action that you must take to accomplish that. I hope that helps you. And always check out the comment section I will put in what I believe would be of most help to you. Having a system shortens the process, and that's what I use, and it pays me very, very well as well. So I hope you have an awesome, awesome day, and take care and use both gratefulness and dreaming together along with action to really propel yourself to where you really want to be. I hope you have an awesome day. Bye for now.